Well, hi, glad to see you. So listen, maybe you once had to wake up before 6 a.m. for an early flight and think you could never do it regularly. But trust us, it's totally worth it. This habit can be the wake-up call you need to get out of a monotonous routine. Keep watching to learn why successful people are early risers, why you should be too, and how the habit can make you more self-aware and increase your confidence. Now, don't forget to click the subscribe button and turn on notifications to join us on the bright side of life. Counting down from number 7, time for exercise. Are you more likely to hit the gym after you've had a long day at work and all you want to do is rest? Or in the morning when you've had a full night of refreshing sleep? Biologically, testosterone reaches its highest levels in men in the early morning. So if you exercise at the crack of dawn, you can be more efficient at building muscle. Exercise is also known to increase your energy levels, boost your mood, and enhance your focus. Would you rather get these benefits as you're about to tackle the day or right before you head to bed? There's also a better chance that you'll get your workout done if you tackle it in the morning. In the afternoons, you might be faced with interruptions from the people you live with, a new work assignment might keep you late at work, or you might have to help your child with their homework. If you work out first thing in the morning, you're ensuring that it happens. Another nice perk is that the earlier you rise, the less chance there is that someone will be occupying your favorite treadmill. Number 6. Meditation time. Rising early can grant you time to yourself without any interruptions. If you live with children or a large family, it might be hard to get any peace and quiet throughout the day. If you follow the standard 9-to-5 schedule, by the time you get home, your kids are already there and expecting dinner. You then spend the rest of the night doing chores or resting while surrounded by people. Everybody needs some time to themselves. If you can't fit it into your schedule, you can achieve it by waking up early. In those quiet morning moments, when nothing and no one stirs, you can self-soothe, engage in a hobby, or meditate. Meditation is known to reduce stress and anxiety, improve your quality of sleep, give you a better sense of self-awareness, and allow you to have a better sense of peace overall. Taking up meditation first thing in the morning can transform how you tackle the rest of your day. Number 5. Better sleep. Heading to bed early and rising early is also good for your sleep. If you rise early, you expend your energy from the beginning of your day onward, and your energy meter, so to speak, would become lower and lower throughout the day. By the time 9 p.m. comes, you'll be ready to collapse in bed. You might fall asleep as soon as your head hits the pillow and sleep like a log throughout the night. This is a better option than being wide awake at night because you overslept earlier or being tired and wanting to sleep but being unable to. If you wake up before 6 a.m., you don't have to worry about not being able to fall asleep at night. Remember Benjamin Franklin, early to bed and early to rise makes a man healthy, wealthy, and wise. And women too. Number 4. It can be empowering. Many people go about their daily routine, day after day, with a feeling that they don't have much control over their lives. Between strict work schedules, family commitments, and household chores, it can be hard to establish time to check if you like how your life is going. Waking up before 6 a.m. can give you that time and the sense that you are in control of your life. This quiet time will allow you to hear your own opinions on how you feel, what you want to do for the day, and if you want to accomplish something really special. You can also set personal goals. This will be a much more proactive way to tackle your day than simply waking up, getting ready, heading to work, resting, and then repeating the routine the next day. It's no coincidence that Harvard biologist Christoph Randler says that early risers are more proactive and identify with statements like, "I feel in charge of making things happen." Number 3. Unlock your creative power. If you work in a creative field like drawing, writing, painting, or filmmaking, rising early can be beneficial to you. They say the early bird catches the worm for good reason. One of them is that your brain is at its sharpest in the morning. A 2013 study published in the Journal of Neurophysiology found that the prefrontal cortex, which is vital to the creative process, is at its most active just after waking up. The analytical part of the brain, which is used by people like editors and proofreaders, seems to be the most active later in the evening. By using MRI scans, the study discovered that the brain has more of the connections necessary for the creative process in the morning. This approach might not be a one-size-fits-all, but if you've been struggling with writer's block, you can give yourself a biological boost by handling creative work in the morning. Number 2. Time shared with other family members. For many people, the morning routine can be so hectic that it doesn't allow any quality family time. Everyone's rushing to get ready, get to the school bus on time, and make it on time to work. This might mean that families are barely connecting in the morning, there's no bonding, and everything from getting ready to having breakfast to saying goodbye is done in a rush. If you want to be closer to your family but don't know where to fit it into your schedule, the morning is a great time to check in with everyone and agree on how the day's gonna go. If there are usually misunderstandings in your family about the daily schedule, you can review the responsibilities for the day in the morning. You can get a cup of coffee with your partner before you both head to work or have breakfast with the kids. Number 1. Successful people do it. What do some of the world's most successful people have in common? Well, besides wads of cash, they are early risers and attribute part of their success to their morning routine. Apple CEO Tim Cook wakes up at 3:45 a.m. LinkedIn CEO Jeff Weiner wakes up at 5:30 a.m. Richard Branson wakes up at 5:45 a.m. Dwayne Johnson, also known as The Rock, wakes up at 4 a.m. These successful people wake up early so that they have time to exercise, meditate, read the paper, catch up on world events, and get their bearings before they start their workday. By taking time in the morning, they're able to take care of their bodies physically and prepare themselves mentally for the day. Their early routine allows them to establish daily goals and avoid following a monotonous routine at work. So, are you convinced that waking up before 6 a.m. is the best thing for you? If you want to unlock all the benefits of early rising, it can seem daunting at first to change your sleep schedule, but you can do it with these tips. Start going to bed early. Don't skimp on the recommended sleep hours in an effort to wake up early because it will be counterproductive. Shoot for 7 to 8 hours of sleep if you're an adult. If you're a teen, go for 8 to 10 hours. If you can, head outside first thing in the morning. The circadian clock operates based on daylight, so getting a bit of sun when you wake up will help it reset and make it easier for you to wake up early. Don't oversleep on the weekends. If you rise early on weekdays but sleep until 10 a.m. on the weekends, you'll end up feeling terrible. Before long, you'll quit your new morning routine. Sleeping in can confuse your circadian clock and leave you with a sense of jet lag. Yeah, not fun. So, keep rising early for the weekends, even if you decide to stay in bed. So tell us, Brightsiders, what will you do with your mornings if you wake up before 6 a.m.? Let us know in the comment section. Don't forget to give this video a like, share it with your friends, and click subscribe to stay on the bright side.